Sapphire's VHS Damage is a great way of degrading your image and reliving a beautiful analog past. My name is Ben Brownlee for Boris Effects, and I'm going to show you how to get started with VHS Damage. Now, I'm going to be using Premiere Pro as my main host, but just know that everything I show you is going to be relevant to you, regardless of whatever host you are working on. Now, I'm also not going to apply VHS Damage to a single clip. Instead, I'm going to apply it to a sequence, or at least part of a sequence. I think this is the most flexible way of working. Now, in Premiere Pro, to do this, I'm going to come down and create up a new adjustment layer, and that's going to be the same size as my sequence, and I'm just going to drag this over into a free track on top of all the other clips that I want to affect. Let's come into our effects and do a search for VHS Damage, and I'm going to apply this over here, and it's going to give us a default look. So let's have a little play back of that. And you can see that even at the default values, we have, you know, quite a few different things going on that are signifying VHS. So if I come into the effect itself, you'll see that this is broken down into several different modules, and each of these modules can be turned off or turned on. So for example, if I turn off sparkles, if I turn off streaks, if I turn off scanlines, we start to get a more simplified version of the effect. So everything can be sort of broken down. We don't always have to have everything fully turned up. Tape noise. You can see what each of these different elements are doing. And having this in a sort of modular way is really, really useful. So this can feel a little bit intimidating when you first start looking at the effect, which is why I would always recommend we start off by clicking on Load Preset. And this will load up the preset browser, and we can very easily just sort of step through the presets that we have here and see if you can find something that kind of takes your fancy. When we're looking at this particular type of effect where we have, you know, lots of fine lines or fine dots, if we're just previewing things in the main preset viewer, we may not be seeing everything as it actually is going to look when you bring it back into your host. And the reason for that is that the viewer here automatically sort of downscales the, or downsamples the image. The image that it's processing out here is 1166 by 655. That's because we are at 30% zoom. So let's come over to TV recording dirty tape. And if I zoom this now to 100%, it's going to take a second, but it's now going to take a look and process this out at 3840 by 2160, so Ultra HD. And we're able to see these fine line patterns that we couldn't see when we were zoomed out. So we can see that all of those kind of just sort of blend into one. So I'd recommend that when you find a preset that you quite like, you just quickly turn the zoom up to 100% just to check out all the fine details before you apply it back into the host. Of course, you can always go back and choose another preset or tweak things up to your heart's content, but it saves a little bit of back and forth. So let's load in that one there. And even though we're working off a preset, we can always carry on customizing this. So maybe I'll change the fast forward amount, change up that band height. And we can see that color bloom has been turned off completely. So maybe we'll turn on color bloom and just bloom up those colors a little bit more. So take the vintage up and we'll take the saturation down slightly. And let's give that a quick preview. Now, one of my favorite things about VHS Damage is the ability to create these lovely analog looks. And, you know, there can be a really nice interplay between those different modules, which sometimes feels a bit surprising and, you know, always feels quite nice and organic. And the final control I want to draw your attention to is mix with source. Maybe you've used a preset that's a little bit too strong for your footage and you want just an easy way of bringing that back in. We just use mix with source. And as we bring this up, we get closer and closer to the original footage. And as this reaches one, we're right the way back at the original clip. So when you're starting out, all these parameters can feel, intimidating. So definitely start with the presets and begin to tweak those to your heart's content. Then when you feel a bit more confident, there's a preset in there called Full Reset, and that sets everything back to kind of like a neutral starting point. And you can then begin to build up your own effect from there. And that is definitely what I would recommend you do. And essentially, that's it. It's really easy to get started with VHS Damage and completely transform your beautiful modern images into this feeling of, you know, technology that had such a huge influence on video of times past. And there's a real sort of emotional connection to it there. Of course, if you want to get into more details, then check out my longer video where I talk a bit more about VHS as a technology and how it relates back to the VHS Damage effect. My name is Ben Brownlee for Boris Effects, and I'll see you in another VHS Damage tutorial in the past. If you want to give VHS Damage a spin for yourself, then head over to borisfx.com and download a free trial of Sapphire now. Of course, if you have any cool VHS stories that you want to tell me, then drop them in the comments down below.